Personally, I have dealt with an extravagant amount of joint pain. Neck pain, elbow, shoulders, knees, multiple surgeries, multiple visits to orthopedics, chiropractors, massage, even acupuncture. I get it all done to try to maintain my body and keep my body as active and youthful and pain-free as possible. One of the things that I do to help alleviate my pain, part of my every single day regimen, and part of something that I increase if I had an extra heavy workout or I did something that just kind of aggravated an old injury, is taking flavonoid intensive care. Big fancy name for curcumin. We all know turmeric is super, super good. It's an NF kappa B regulator, which is big and fancy, means it stops inflammation in your system. However, a lot of the turmerics that you get over the counter aren't as absorbable as you believe they are. You're peeing and pooping out up to 90% of the supplement that you take in, trying to find a very high bioavailable source, meaning that your body actually absorbs in as much of it as possible, is very rare and typically very costly. Some of the other things that come with this product that are absolutely fantastic that make it work so well, mixed with our curcumin, is going to be fenugreek. Fenugreek is a great herb to open up blood vessels, to relieve pain, to get lymphatic fluids flowing away. That means getting your inflammation to drain out of the tissues. We're also going to have, believe it or not, a rice protein matrix. What's really cool about the rice protein matrix is it comes from hops, another very natural source, same hops that you would make beer out of. They press it, they extract it, they isolate specific compounds from it, and it actually works as a very, very strong inflammation regulator. So it doesn't shut off all the inflammation, just the bad ones. It allows the good inflammation that actually allows your body to heal to continue going on in the body. Here's one that you're probably not familiar with unless you are a Chinese herbalist. Frankincense, right? Frankincense and myrrh, you've heard about it from as many religious texts. Frankincense is actually an incredibly good pain-relieving substance. It can be taken internally and rubbed on topically to help move blood stagnation, to break up bruises, trauma, to help heal wounded tissues and damaged cells. Absolutely fantastic. That's why it's so precious. It's mentioned in those books. And also, too, another great one, this one you've definitely heard of but probably never thought of as a medicinal, ginger. Ginger is not only a very strong antimicrobial, meaning that it helps fight infections, but it itself also causes blood vessels to open up, fluids to circulate faster, allowing more blood and healthy nutrition to come to the area and allowing all that waste product stuck in the lymphatic flow to be drained away from the area. So in flavonoid intensive care, take it just like it says on the bottle, twice per day, unless I'm injured, then I speak to my healthcare practitioner or myself to figure out what my personal dosage is, but something very, very safe to use on a regular basis for long-term periods and in high dosage in the case that you are injured. Something that I used to rehab my arm surgery and allowed me to get back to exercising in 7.5 weeks when I was supposed to start exercising and starting PT at the 8-week mark. So I was already back to 100% a week before I was supposed to start physical therapy. And one of the things I owe it to is in flavonoid intensive care. So check it out for yourself and enjoy that pain-free living.